We're here today to see a heifer weighing session which is being run for us by Franklin Vets. Franklin Vets regularly monitor the performance of their client's stock at their contract grazing operation here at Emerald Downs, just to make sure that the clients are getting peak performance from their animals. Today Franklin Vets will be using electronic ID tags, or EID. They'll be using an EID stick reader, which is going to talk via Bluetooth to a scale head. They'll then take all the information from that operation back to their premises, and they'll download the data to prepare reports for their clients. Regular monitoring of the health of heifers, particularly are they meeting their weight targets, is the way to ensure that you're going to get peak production from your heifers. When you're thinking about what weight should the heifers be, it should be a percentage of their mature live weight that they're reaching at particular milestones. At weaning, they should be 20% of mature live weight. They should be reaching 30% of mature live weight at 6 months and 40% mature live weight at 9 months. By the time they're going out to the bulls, so thinking about coming into puberty, they need to be reaching around 60% of their mature live weight. Mature live weight is particularly important as it's one of the triggers for onset of puberty, and you need for puberty to come on at the right time if you're going to have good heifers which are going to get in calf at the right time. And finally, you need your heifers to be around 90% of the mature live weight they'll end up being once they're 22 months of age. I'm here today with Jess Kringsland of Franklin Vets. She's kindly agreed to talk to us about some of the most important things for people to consider when they're sending their heifers out to contract grazing. Thanks for being with us here today, Jess.
No worries.
At what stage do you take on young animals?
So we take on R1s, usually around the beginning of November. So that way we hope that they have been weaned properly and weaned at the right weights and had their meal and weaned off meal, and they're all ready to come, good weight, ready to eat grass, or have been eating grass. And perfect just to slot in.
What's a good weight?
So we like to take on Friesians at least 120 kilos. Obviously you're weaning around 100, 110, depending on the individual people and what they like to do. And then crossbreds around 100, and Jerseys we like to be up around the 90 to 100 as well, just because they're a bit softer, we find, so they take a bit longer to get used to the different, the grazing environment and being grazed in big mobs and things. Usually the Jerseys arrive a lot smaller, so that's a tricky one, but we work through it.
So how often are you monitoring the progress of the animals?
So we weigh every 6 weeks, and that's drenching every 6 weeks as well. So at every weigh, we weigh the mob, we assess any that may be doing a poor growth rate or not looking so good. We then go back to the clinic, download all the weights, fly any through to minder weights if that's what the client wants, and then we sit down and do a report and report back, send a hard copy and an email copy to the clients. That happens every 6 weeks, weigh in every 6 weeks, report to the client every 6 weeks. When they get a little bit older, so now we're mating, we tend to push that out a little bit, just so that we're not interfering with them mating and having the bulls in there and things like that. So we will push it out to probably 8 to 10 weeks this time, bring them in just before Christmas, and then we'll only do it a couple of times between Christmas and when they go home in May. So as younger calves, we normally have more problems, so we like to keep monitoring them real closely. And if there's any problems across the mob, we'll bring them in more regularly, so every 3 to 4 weeks, just to make sure that if we've had to make any changes, that they're back on track and things like that. So
that would be things that you'd picked up previously.
So if we do a weigh and on a majority of the mob haven't done as good as we'd hoped, we would then bring them in earlier next time, maybe 4 weeks, just depending on what we find, 4 weeks, and reassess, weigh them all again and see how they're going, because obviously in that 4 weeks we've made changes, maybe needing to feed them more or get in a supplement or something. If we have the individual animals that haven't done well, they'll get assessed while they're in the crush. And if there isn't anything, health-wise that we can find wrong, we may just let them run with the mob still and just check them again next time. Or we'll draft them out and put them into a hospital mob that we have. And so any scrawny animals or anything that's not doing so well or needs treatments or anything like that goes into the hospital mob. And they'll stay in there until the next round of weighing. And if they're good, if their growth rates have been good, they'll get put back in with their mob. Mm. Yeah.
So how interested are the clients in how their animals are doing?
There's a very wide variety. You've got, you know, your one client that's on you every 6 weeks, ringing you, wanting to know what the weights were. If you're a week late, they'll be ringing you, wondering what's going on. You know, sometimes when we're weighing in the busy times of the year, the reports may come out 2 weeks after we've weighed. And so once again, those clients will be ringing you, oh, where's my report? I haven't seen my report yet. Or you'll get the complete opposite extreme when they don't care. They just say that we know you'll ring us if there's something wrong. We know you send us good heifers home. Just, you know, just go for it. So, and I like that. That's easy.
I bet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Any pitfalls of getting the stock in?
Yep. So as I mentioned before, we like them to be a certain weight when they arrive. We like them to be well weaned and just used to pasture and that's it. A lot of the time we get calves that, actually it's not so bad now, we've kind of culled out a few, but we used to get calves arrive with a ton of meal, and so we'd have to be feeding up meal because they hadn't been weaned fully yet. Or we'd get calves that would arrive, you know, Jersey calves that would arrive that were 60 to 70 kilos, and they can't just be chucked straight out on pasture and just expected to grow. And at that weight, they're well below target for their age. And so, I mean, most clients are pretty good. They know that if you send calves that are below target, then, you know, you can't expect your heifers to be well grown, well above target when they arrive home. But that's where the data, you know, weighing every 6 weeks, making sure you're doing a weigh when they first arrive, so you've got that information. And then if you have any problems at the end of it, when you send them home, you can look back and you can see that data from when they first arrived and what weights they were and things like that. And you can then also, you've got your growth rates as well, you know, when you're weighing every 6 weeks. So you can show them that it took them a while to actually get used to what they were eating and that they just chucked out there on grass. And yeah, so you certainly learn a lot.
So why is it important that heifers are reaching the weight target?
Weight targets, yeah. So we have certain growth rate targets throughout the year, and they go up and down depending on age, breed, time of year. But we've got two weight targets, which is a mating target, and then we have the plans that are calving target. So they normally go home 1 to 2 months before plans that are calving. So our growth rates, our target growth rates, get us through to make sure that we're hitting that mating target, and then it gets us through again to make sure we'll be hitting that plans that are calving target. So you want to reach the mating target well and truly, so that you've got well-grown heifers. They will be cycling early, they'll be getting in calf early. And then usually, if you do well with your calves, you have stronger R2s, and so they tend to do better as well anyway. And then, you know, for planned starter calving, you want your animals to be at the target so that they're going to calve down easily. They're going to be, you know, in a good position to just jump straight into the herd. They'll be nice, well-grown heifers. If you've got a scrawny heifer, it's going to get picked on by the cows, and they'll just go into peak lactation really well. And so a lot of our clients, they comment about how, you know, the production's awesome in their heifers because they're really well-grown. But also, you know, right back as calves, you've got to have that good growth rate and get them up to that target for mating, because that's where all their frame size comes from and things like that. So, you know, you might have scrawny, and then you expect them to all of a sudden just blossom into these big, well-grown heifers, but you're not going to get that. You need to get them growing well in the beginning to get that frame size. They might look lanky and scrawny. Well, they're not scrawny, but you know, they don't really quite look right with their bit out of proportion with their big frame size, but then you can fill that. Whereas if it's not there in the beginning, then you're going to struggle. And then, you know, you're going to have big heifers, big frames, calve easily, won't be at the bottom of the pecking order when they get into the herd and things like that. So yeah, it's really important to have well-grown heifers. And also, you know, if they're at the bottom of the pecking order, they're going to be more prone to disease and ill health and things like that. So yeah, and that's also why we don't here we quite often join mobs together because it's easier to run bigger mobs here. But we actually don't have jerseys on farm anymore. But when we did, we had to run the jerseys as a separate mob and as a smaller mob because they're quite soft, especially as heifers. You know, they like the flat areas. They don't like going down big hills and through streams and stuff like that. So they've got to stay in a Jersey mob, otherwise they get picked on by the big Frisians. And so yeah, that's the other thing, is having to watch out for your smaller ones. And yeah, that's why it's good they're all big, strong, strapping animals. Yeah,
cool. Okay, thanks for that, cool. Jess, appreciate it.
No worries.
Thanks for your time today.
No worries, thank you.